News is a family-owned and operated establishment that's been a staple in downtown Lynn for over 50 years. Whether you're looking for hard-to-find local and national newspapers or magazines, the greatest selection of cigars on the North Shore, or state lottery in Keno, Cal's is there for you. Head down to 53 Central Ave in Lynn today for great selection, great prices, and award-winning service.
Monday night, San Fran travels to Lambeau on the best day of the week.
Mr. Munn is a teacher. Yeah, all my students. I'm on a hot streak 4 in a row. Montana's not coming through that door. Young's not coming through that door. Jimmy G's on a stretcher. Where's Kaepernick? Frozen tundra. Frozen tundra. Frozen tundra. Vince Lombardi. Vince Lombardi. Aaron Rodgers has a beard. The Packers line likes the double team! Take the pack! Take the Packers! Better the Packers! Cheeseheads! Mr. Monday can't be stopped! Monday! Woo! Monday! From the
Chicago! What's up? A couple of gomadas.
Monday!
How's everyone doing tonight? I'm Carlo, Mr. Monday. This is the I Love Monday Night live show. My co-host, Mikey Machine Gun Schena. How you doing?
Wonderful. Yeah. I'm good, my man.
That's good.
All right.
How you doing, Klesk?
I'm feeling great, man.
Yeah. What about the sports day we had yesterday? Let's talk about that real quick.
That was nice, huh?
Socks, pats. You know, big wins.
Everybody making fun of David Price. Price comes out of nowhere.
They're calling him priceless. That's what they should call
him. Still, they still pitched. He won with them, so that's good.
I know. He finally got a victory. And he was humble, I got to say. Yeah. You know, he looks a little screwy with that beard.
Yeah. He's going after this year, but whatever.
But so what about the? What do you like tonight in the game?
I like the Bay. I like the Bay. Yeah, all day long. They're playing Medford High or something.
It's a layup.
That's just easy. They're done.
It's a layup tonight.
Absolutely.
I put your money on the Packers tonight, everybody. I think I made that pretty clear.
Absolutely. Pretty clear.
All right, let's go right into shoot the shit. Okay. Amazon scraps secret A1 recruiting tool that didn't like females.
Amazon ended job recruiting services that was based biases against women. Basically, they have this like artificial intelligence thing. It's a computer thing, and it goes through keywords that might be on a resume, words that might stand out, like, you know, argued with boss, or 100 late days, or I'm a female. And it took all those and put them at the bottom of the pile, and those people didn't get a job. People are upset about that.
Sounds like people don't like Mondays, actually, all those questions and stuff.
I guess. I don't know. Mondays, they basically don't like women. If you have a vagina, you are going to the bottom of the pile. And I don't know. People, I guess, have a lawsuit.
I mean, who doesn't like women, Mike?
Oh, McCluskey.
What? You don't have to.
Sure. What is it with you two? There's always something going on. How are you feeling tonight, Andy, by the way? You feeling good?
I'm all right.
You don't
know.
Again,
you're going to break my balls in front of everybody again?
No, I'm just saying. You usually have an ailment.
I do. I got to go get one of those upper GI things. You know, when you got to go to bed and they look down your throat. Kind of like McCluskey every night, but you're awake when they do it. But, I gotta get up your GI. There's something going on, man. We gotta really? Figure it out. Oh,
I hope
keep on breaking my balls. Yeah, yeah.
I hope you're okay.
But you're ready to laugh at me. I know.
I'm teasing you. Jesus. Now I feel like a jerk.
God, I hope I die and I haunt you for the rest of your life.
So what was this thing exactly? This A1.
It's AI. It's artificial intelligence.
Insemination.
Yeah, this is an AI. Can't put this.
I'm sick of Amazon. I'm sick of hearing about these people.
Old news.
No, but it's discriminating against women, but it's following an algorithm that this computer system thinks will get the best candidate. So imagine like it mathematically just said, oh, this candidate could potentially have a baby and be out for 9 months, and it calculated that in. It might reduce their likeliness of being chose, but you know, apparently that's not fair.
Real people, computers, bullshit. You know, I don't know. Had enough. All right, next one. Women arrested after texting a cop who she thought was her drug dealer.
Ooh, Audrey Bigica? Is it Bigica?
It's Bigica, you fake Italian.
Bigica?
Bigica.
You said it good.
Bigica.
He says it nice. It's like you're singing.
Such an extra.
Audrey Bigica, 23, texted a wrong number while allegedly trying to obtain meth. She ended up reaching a Wyoming police officer instead on his department-issued cell phone. Officer Sapp played along, and he pretended that he had meth to deliver, and then she was arrested. She pleaded not guilty. So I can plead not guilty, but she
why
did.
Does she have a cop's number one? Because she was probably the cop was probably banging her in the back
seat. Yeah, he's a dirty cop.
Okay, why does she have his number, first of all? That's what I'd like to know.
Meth fingers. They always miss by like one or two digits when they're typing it in. I don't know.
But I mean, the cop should be arrested. That's like a setup.
Exactly.
You're like setting up this chick.
Is there a warrant?
Yeah, that's like doing cocaine and playing Operation. Your fingers are all. You're gonna be a lot of buzzing.
No. Yeah. I don't know. Something sounds shady. Something's fake on that whole thing.
It's an inside job.
Yeah. I think he was banging her.
I think so.
All right, next. What do we got? Naked wannabe rap star tries to shoot a rap video during a church service.
Zachary Burdick, 21, was arrested after masturbating during a church service. Burdick allegedly bathed in holy water before touching himself in the aisle. Earlier, he'd been asked to leave the Spirit of Life Catholic Church in North Dakota. Police say he'd been trying to bless people and hand out Mormon literature. There were preschool children present at the time of his lewd behavior, and he was also accused of being on methamphetamine. I just think the only problem here is that he was naked and touching himself in his church, and he was over 14, I guess.
I mean, some things aren't sacred anymore, church. You can't even...
He brought a gun to church?
He had a gun on him?
I didn't see anything with a gun. He was handling a different type of unit.
He had like a skin flapper gun? What do you have?
Sex pistol!
Meat hook?
Yeah. He was lubricating his genitals with holy water and rapping while walking down the aisles.
So her last name is Burdick. Is that a real last name, Burdick?
Burdick. It's how cold his penis felt when he was walking around a church naked.
Sounds like a rap.
Jesus.
Isn't that disgusting? Like, God, so this is probably for some kid's YouTube channel, and I mean, we really shouldn't talk because we're trying to do the same thing, but none of us, except for Mike, have whipped out our penis in a church.
Yeah, but at least it was with the nun when you did it.
Yeah, you know what?
It wasn't like with the priest.
Exactly. Half a man.
Yeah, Mike doesn't get to give in that scenario.
Donkey. Hurry up, you extra. Go to the next one.
This guy was like in the church and he's trying to like do a rap video. He's trying to save on production costs.
Forget about that. He was doing something in front of kids. Forget about him rapping. He's whipping all his thing.
I know. And you got
sicko.
And you were just talking about kids and how you feel about your kids.
Please.
No, I know. What if your daughters were there?
He would have been dead. What do you mean if my daughter's there?
Good.
I would have
given him a beating too.
Yeah.
Again, this is all alleged. He might not have been masturbating. He might have just been making the sign of the cross on his penis. We don't know.
Does he have hands?
Oh, God. All right, let's watch this next video. A man shoots another guy in the leg while his two little kids watch in a road rage.
Oh, man, I love these. So, you know, Middleton police were alerted to reports shot fired at a block off of Dixie Highway. It was like 9:40 at night. Jessica Payne and Chase Harris, they were both 25. They were found near the vehicle with an infant. You know, a basic road rage case, and nobody's taken into consideration that there's kids walking around. Guns are happening. People are driving like animals.
Right.
And as we see here,
Dixie
someone
Highway,
escalates
what's that, Florida?
This.
Everything happens in Florida.
We like to blame that. Yeah, like instead of doing the research or like remembering things, we go with them.
What do you think? I think this sounds like a premeditated like affair.
Yeah, because if he was really, he was shot him in the head, right? He shot him right in the leg. Yeah,
this guy was
a statement.
This pain person was charged with attempted felonious assault and child endangering.
So Mr. Howard and Mrs. Payne, I think, had something going on. That sounds like who the two people are. Is that their names?
Those are their names, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, something's weird here.
Something's odd, and like, right. What do you do with it? What do you do with those people? Like, do you get a ticket and like rehabilitation, and then they can go back with their kids, or should we just like
get married to each other because they were definitely doing something?
Yeah,
they had something going on.
I think that we should put all those kids in like one of those like National Lampoon's Family style cars. Tell them they're going to Disney World. Fill it with carbon monoxide and move on with our lives, right?
Jesus Christ, McCluskey.
All right, next. Yeah. San Francisco is declared poop capital of the world.
Yeah.
The Californian city was far worse than competitors New York and Chicago for both human and dog excrement complaints. That's for the last year. 2017 was the dirtiest year so far in San Francisco, but 2018 will likely be worse. Bigger poops are expected, I guess. The city launched Poop Patrol in August to clean up before complaints were filed. Locals blame politicians for ignoring the steadily worsening problems. Basically, there's an app here, and people are posting every time they find a pile of human or dog crap.
Human, huh?
Yeah, and this is in San Francisco. Those are all San Francisco shits.
Shouldn't it be up the poop chute, capital of the world, if you're in San Francisco?
I think. Well, actually, that's one of the benefits of it being in San Francisco is all the craps are smaller because they've been condensed before they came out of the butts. I don't know why it would be more
what
like
about
that.
Rice-A-Roni? Remember Rice-A-Roni? Wasn't
San Francisco treat?
Yeah. I mean, they're famous for Rice-A-Roni in the hills, San Francisco, you know.
That's now, see that? You see, it's scaled, right? Because that's a big. San Francisco's not small.
San Francisco's a big city, right?
I bet you those are all tiny little brown rice balls floating around.
So are people going around whipping their pants down, crapping everywhere? Is the dogs?
A lot of homeless people. So, yeah. A lot of homeless people there.
Crapping outside?
Open air shitting.
Where are they
going to
go?
It's a new thing. And what's even crazier is, all right, this is how many people are taking a shit out in the open. Then there's people following them around and taking pictures of other people's shit and putting them online. I'm more likely to be the guy shitting than taking pictures of other people's.
What about like over here? We got the bag. You're supposed to pick up the dog's crap. They don't have that law over there?
No, we don't get to have those Stop and Shop bags anymore. You got to pay 10 cents a piece for those. So unless you want to get your hands dirty.
What's a San Francisco bullseye? Have you ever heard of that?
Isn't that like when you put a like one of those tennis ball containers on the ground and you have to fill it from a tree? No?
No, I thought it was something else. I thought you might have known. Do you have it? What about cats? I mean, the cat shitting over there too? I think they bury that crap.
No, they get the cat. Yeah, they bury it, don't they?
Doesn't someone walk their cat in your neighborhood?
Oh, what a weird. She's got a leash on the thing. Like it's normal.
What kind of cat is it?
I have no idea, man. She needs a leash. That's crazy.
Yeah, nut job.
All right, what's next? We're going to check out this morning's Monday episode at the Tossville Fair. And then we come back. We got Sarah Nehf, a former Lingerie Football League player and a UNLV volleyball standout. We'll be right back.
Beautiful. Yeah!
Monday morning. Everyone else, I don't know what they're doing. On Mondays, I know what I'm doing. I'm going up to the fair today. Have a blast. It's a Monday. What are you doing on a Monday? I know, you're being miserable.
How are we doing?
Good. Been done. Oh, my God, no.
You worried about getting deported? That's a great hat.
Follow the neck.
Okay, nice lid.
Okay,
nice. Nice.
Sunday!
Sure doesn't smell like a Monday morning in this place. Whoa. What language is that? What language are you speaking? How you doing? These things will bite you. Listen, I don't want to go to the hospital on a Monday, okay? Come on, get off your fat ass. Let's go. Turn around, Sally. Hey, Liberace, come here. Liberace, what are you so scared for?
Monday!
Oh, good. It's like the Tony the Tiger bird.
Monday!
Ooh, that's a majestic call you have there, Mr. Monday. Ooh, that's beautiful.
Yes.
Monday!
He doesn't even sit down and read the newspaper. He just lets it go.
Monday!
It's just Monday, though.
It's a Monday. It's a new internet sensation. You haven't seen it?
No.
What the hell? Where you been? Living under a rock?
Apparently.
What's wrong with you?
I hate Mondays.
Monday!
I love to milk this cow. Whoa. Jesus Christ. Is that tail going to come up again?
Monday!
Have you heard of Mr. Monday? Have you heard of Mr. Monday?
I have never heard of Mr. Monday.
Internet sensation, Mr. Monday, no?
Oh, yeah.
You haven't heard about it? No, unbelievable.
Someone asked me, he's like, who the hell is Mr. Monday?
Yeah. Well, now you know. You know, he's this big, goofy-looking guy. You know what I'm saying?
Really? I'll have to check it out.
Monday!
There's no doubt in my mind you love Mondays. If you're going to get a tattoo on your face, you got to love Mondays.
I hate Mondays. I work 7 days a week.
Really?
Yeah.
Come on.
I hate Mondays.
But you love to work.
I love to work.
Let's tell me about the tattoos. What do they mean?
Well, it means love. It means I don't give a you know?
All right.
Yeah, I got you. You know, it's just love myself. That's it.
Monday!
What's going on, Monday. Jeanette? Yeah, yes.
Hi.
What's up?
Same second.
We got one of our Monday fans right here.
Look at there that. You go.
Oh, this guy's stepping in.
Monday!
So tell me about this joint. Tell me about your joint.
Right. This is Bob's Burger Joint, right? We've been in business since 1956.
You and your family started it?
Family started it.
Really?
Yep. I've been here 40 years since I was 14 years old. I met my first wife here.
Really? What about your second wife? Where'd you meet her?
At my divorce party.
Monday!
Hey! Everybody, eat us Monday!
Yeah. Best day of the week!
Best day of the week!
Now look at now you love it. You just hated it. I turned you. That's right. Is it true about the French?
What about them?
They fight with their feet, with their face.
All right, so unfortunately, I cannot comment.
Oh, because it's true.
Yeah.
Mr. Monday's a stud muffin.
I mean, you know, the poor thing needs glasses.
I love Monday.
How tough was it being in Las Vegas? I mean, were you guys allowed to go to the casinos or you weren't 21?
I never did. I never really had a desire to, and I don't know if that's just been my discipline from being an athlete my whole life, but it's not really an issue with a lot of student athletes at UNLV. It's like you're so busy with practice and games and travel and class that you really shouldn't have time to get in trouble. So
I would have got thrown out of college if I was out there.
That's what everybody says. Yeah,
no question about it. So yeah. So you graduated college and then you went on to play in a pro football league?
Yeah, I played in the Lingerie Football League. They had just switched the name from Lingerie to Legends Football League. And that was probably the best experience that I had.
Really?
Football-wise, because I've always been the girl that just wanted to watch football. And that's like my thing that me and my dad did every Sunday. We go have brunch, we watch football. And I never really had other girlfriends that were into football like that. And so when I went to tryouts and started playing with these girls and just listening to them talk about football, I was like, these are who I'm supposed to be with.
My
quarterback is amazing. Her football IQ is just crazy, and she throws the ball as good as any guy I've ever seen throw a ball. So it was really cool. That was a really awesome experience.
Now, was that 1 year?
That was 1 year. The Las Vegas Sin actually wasn't a team after that. So a bunch of the girls are actually playing for the LA Temptation right now. They literally drive to LA for practice and games from Vegas. But I went to the WFL, the Women's Football League. So it's 11 on 11, full pads, helmet, college rules. We just played on a high school field. But my same quarterback from LFL went there. So I just kind of followed her.
So the Lingerie Football League, it's a little more lax, I mean, I would think.
Not at all.
It's as competitive as the...
Oh, yeah.
Really?
If not more. Just because the girls that play in the LFL are so athletic. And I don't think people really realize that. Like, do you know who Danica Brace is? You ever heard of Danica Brace?
No.
So she was my middle linebacker. And right now she's actually coaching the team in Nashville. So she's the first female coach ever in the LFL, and they went undefeated this last season. But she is the most physical, athletic female specimen I've ever seen in my life. And she hits hard. She plays hard. She's so talented and just like the sweetest girl ever too. It's like everybody in the LFL is super driven and athletic and just like they're out there to hurt people, basically. Yeah.
How hard do you guys hit? Is it like crazy hard impact? Is it concussion protocol and everything too, just like regular football?
Yeah, because they gave you hockey helmets.
Oh, that's what you...
Yeah.
Who supplied the lingerie? That's what I want to know.
So it's not really lingerie. It started that way, but it's more just like boy shorts and a sports bra. And now they have pants, I think, actually, because so many girls, we play on turf. So a lot of girls were getting like really bad turf burns. So I know they have pants for them now, but yeah, it was just like boy shorts and a sports bra, not straight up lingerie.
So it's sports gear. It wasn't like, you know, Victoria's Secret stuff that you guys. Okay. All right.
No.
I mean, I remember, wasn't there a halftime show?
That's how it started.
The Super Bowl. It was like a halftime show 1 year.
Yeah, the Lingerie Bowl.
The Lingerie Bowl. That was probably
I think they wore lingerie in that.
Yeah.
And then everyone was like, okay, if we're going to get actual athletes, we can't have them out here in lace.
So you're not playing football anymore?
No.
Are you bummed out or what?
Yeah. I thought about playing in a flag football league out here, so I still might
do that. I was going to ask you if you played. I mean, there's got to be leagues, you know, like flag leagues and stuff.
Yeah, there's flag leagues.
Now, tell us about your fantasy football, because I think that might intimidate guys, by the way.
Yeah.
You find guys are intimidated by that? Because, like, you're like, you know, a pretty girl, you're athletic. Do guys get intimidated by you?
Probably. You know?
I would think so. You could probably beat up half of them.
I kind of try to do it, so.
Yeah, you really?
Yeah. So, I've been playing fantasy football for a long time. And I'm really close with my dad. I talk to him a lot about just football in general. And he would just always crack up about all the things that I would talk about with my fantasy team. Like, I hate kickers. I hate kickers. And kickers always ruin it for me. Never fails. And so I would just call him and basically bitch about it all the time. And he was just like, you know what? You should just film yourself when you're complaining about your fantasy league and then see if you can give picks and predictions and stuff like that and see what happens and see if people like it. So I told him I would do it last year and I didn't. And then this year I was just like, whatever. I'll give it a shot.
So that's how it started.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Or maybe he just got sick of me bitching and wanted me to do it to my phone instead of to him.
Yeah, I can't do fantasy. It just drives me crazy. I get too obsessed with it, and I just go nuts.
Fantasy made football more enjoyable for me because I used to only want to watch Bronco games because I didn't really care about anybody else. And then when I started playing fantasy, I was like, oh, now I got something going every game. So
and you can make some
money. I love
money.
Fantasy.
Have a great day. Right. Thank you.
You too. Thanks for having me on.
Thank you very much.
All right, bye.
Bye.
Cafe Avellino is a slice of heaven nestled into the picturesque coastline of historic Swampscott, with an amazing cook-to-order breakfast menu served all day, homemade pastries, and a wide variety of coffees. This is the perfect place to start your day. Lunch and dinner includes signature paninis, daily specials, and the option to BYOB. Head down to 242 Humphrey Street or call today at 781-584-4435.
Frozen Tundra! Frozen Tundra! Oh, man. All right, welcome back. Welcome back, everyone.
It's Monday.
So, Klusky, this Kavanaugh thing, this debacle's over.
Yeah.
All right. Now he's been sworn in to the Supreme Court. He's a judge now. But I heard you got something else on him.
We have actually some breaking news on that story. But before we get to it, the reason we're able to come to you with these breaking stories is because we have great sponsors. And today's sponsor, one of our sponsors, is John's Roast Beef. Again, set up a beautiful spread. Roast beefs, chicken kebabs, buffalo fingers. Everything is delicious.
Tasso, I just ate your Greek god.
Yeah. Go to John's
good
Roast
stuff,
Beef.
Good stuff.
Stuff your face. The place is great.
You like Tasso's food?
It's terrific.
All right. Well, on that one, we're going to jump into the next segment. As I said, this is a big deal here, okay?
Okay.
The decision's been made about the Kavanaugh situation, but, you know, the American people still have questions, okay?
Okay.
We went the extra mile. Yep. We have some in-depth reporters who went out there, and they went to the Georgetown Preparatory School where this, you know, alleged thing took place in 1982. We found a map.
Nice.
We followed the map, and we dug a hole. And when we dug that hole, we found Kavanaugh's Kavanapsule, a time capsule from 1982 that
beautiful.
Is from Kavanaugh. So, Jen, why don't we bring that out? Let's take a look.
So the Breaking Balls team actually found all this stuff?
Yeah, we have people that went out there and got it. They dug it up.
Hi, Jen. Thank you.
Wow, interesting.
What do you think about Kavanaugh? You think Kavanaugh was guilty?
He was 17. Who cares? I need to get over it.
Thank you. All right, gee,
well
I like
said.
That.
Well
you
said.
Go, America, see? Beautiful.
Well said.
Well said. All right, so what are we doing here? Why don't we pull something out?
Just honestly, we just popped the cap on this. Why don't you pull something out? I don't know what he would have put in here during that time
pull
period.
It out. Okay. Solo cups?
Oh, yeah, that makes sense.
So, solo cups. So.
The half of the things that he's being accused
probably
of.
They were probably playing quarters with it.
No,
exactly.
Beer pong. Yeah.
Exactly.
Beer pong, quarters. Or maybe they didn't want to use glass. He didn't want them using glass because they get the fingerprints on the glass.
Ah, see?
You know what I'm saying? Because he definitely was. Yeah, come on. He did something to this.
You can't get your fingerprints on plastic.
It's fine, whatever he did. I mean. No, you can't get your fingerprints on plastic. It's true.
No.
It's true.
Not the kind they were using in 1982.
No.
What else is in that? This is crazy. I can't believe that, you know.
Stuff.
We unearthed this. Oh, no.
Jesus Christ.
Okay.
She looks like she had bigger breasts than that.
This, I mean, that could be anybody's. That could
what the
be.
Hell are you smelling it for?
Smell
I think
that.
That's my brother's.
Smell that.
It's grossy,
huh? What?
That's a fraternity prank. When
it's
I had to.
Clean, actually.
When you swear in, they make you wear that. That's
yeah, that's all it is. He wore it.
Tomfoolery.
You think he wore it?
Oh, yeah, for sure. Second.
Of course.
I don't know. I think it was a woman.
That could barely contain Kavanaugh's nipples, let alone those C cups he's swinging around in that.
All right. Okay. What else we got in here?
Okay.
There you go.
Duct tape.
All right, for the game with the cups, right? You have to line up the triangle for the cups to
black duct tape.
Yeah,
it's different. Usually gray, isn't it?
Usually.
1982. No.
I think that he hogtied these girls,
sure.
Like taped them up, hogtied them, taped their mouth.
I think this is all because you've heard the story. I think if you just open this up, you'd think that this was like, you know, he was.
I think he taped their nipples too, like,
and then
and ripped it right off.
Nice,
yeah. Tried to get them erect.
Sick. You know? Yeah, for sure. Eyebrows.
They call that the cavern nipple.
Eyebrows. What do you mean eyebrows?
Yeah, it's pain. That's what it was back.
Wait,
in the
someone
day.
Ever do that to you?
Once.
Really?
Once.
Once. Was it a guy or a girl?
Once.
Is there more in there?
Oh. Can you blame the guy?
Tastes great.
Is that?
Is this Les Filling or is it
Schlitz?
Great?
Is that Schlitz from
82?
Didn't he say he didn't drink a lot?
Probably bottled it.
So beer. I mean, this is how we drug the girls, kind of like Cosby.
I look the other way. I say if this guy drank a lot, he wouldn't have forfeited the beer to the time capsule. The guy would have fired it down.
Use it as a bet.
I think he was trying to get these girls drunk with the beer.
I mean, that's an unused roofie vessel. He could have gotten 3 or 4 girls to come back to his room, you know?
Yeah. I mean, the guy definitely did something with the girl. What are you going to do? They were teenagers.
You don't know that. There's nothing even hinting that so far here. We have some crafting devices.
Why are you sticking up for him so much?
I don't understand what we're doing.
He's a weirdo just like him.
We're projecting based on nothing. What else is in this thing? I haven't seen anything to convince me that he's up to no good. Okay,
what's this?
What the hell?
You might
that?
Have me here.
What is that?
This is Abercrombie and Bitch. I don't know. What is that?
Dirty photos right there.
That's an interesting
recipe
photo.
For a pervert,
suggestive
right there.
Photos.
Superb.
Glamour cocks.
Look at these guys. So he's into both men and women.
That's what you get from that picture?
Yeah.
I don't see any women in that picture.
What do you get,
you weirdo? No, I know it's a woman.
Oh, okay.
Is that McCluskey's head on there?
Maybe this whole Brett Kavanaugh thing, maybe he thought the girl was a guy, and this whole thing was a misunderstanding.
I mean, he's married with 2 kids now. You know? He's not. Okay. He's straight.
Well, you know. Devil's Triangle.
What's that?
Quarters.
Exactly.
Playing quarters.
No, they weren't.
The Devil's Triangle.
No, yep. They weren't.
Right?
That's what it is.
What do you think this was for? Tell me what you think this was for.
You know, a little piggy bank in the back. You know what that's for. That's exactly. He's a sick fuck. What? You know where he put those quarters?
Up the cooler?
Yeah, exactly. It's a piggy bank. I know that for a fact.
McCluskey, you're not going to like this. I think he lured these girls in, said you get free parking. Now I'm going to give you some quarters. You got... okay?
Maybe that's a
you
goal.
Got, you got you some... Go. I got beers. I got quarters. I got duct tape. Come on, we're going to have a game. He gives them free parking, gets them in there.
I think he was playing 250.
You know
250
something?
Is where you put 250
this guy
in.
Should be our judge. He's a genius.
Yeah, we should go with this
That's guy. A good move. That's a good move, buddy. All right. So what do we got next? I heard we got some type of new twist from an old segment.
Yeah,
the Monday old segment.
Yeah, we polished off an old bit. This one is make out or stake out, where you're going to decide whether or not you'd like to make out with somebody or go over undercover on a stake out to prove that they did something wrong, which would incriminate them and then send them to jail forever.
Okay.
All right.
So that'd be good.
So ruin somebody's life or put your tongue in their mouth. This 40-something crazy woman has 1 million adopted kids from the Congo, and she's been nominated for an Oscar. She played a man in the 2010 movie Salt. Mr. Monday, would you rather make out with her or stake out Angelina Jolie?
Honestly, I'd rather neither. I don't like her at all.
What's your
problem?
She
goes to the Congo and adopts all these kids. I mean, stay in America and help the kids around here. Help our own people. You want to go over there? She's full of crap. You guys like that? We're Americans. Right? Can we talk about America? America! But I mean, seriously, she goes to other countries and adopts kids.
Yeah.
Stay with, so many kids in Lynn over here.
Shitting on the ground.
It's easier to adopt a kid in the Congo because you can't lock a tent.
How many boyfriends and husbands has she had, by the way?
She went out with a bunch of
people. Yeah, let's talk about who she's gone out with.
I think Clooney she went out with.
Yeah, she went out with Clooney. I mean,
that other guy, who's that wig?
She unraveled
Santa Claus.
She unraveled his dick.
Billy
Bob Thornton. And Brad Pitt.
Brad Pitt got rid of her. Guy. Yeah, Jerry Cooney. There you go.
Jerry Cooney, the fighter.
Who? Richie LaMontagne.
Yeah, Richie LaMontagne, the underwear model. Really? Well, you guys, I think Richie and her would have looked good
together. Mike, you didn't even name 13. You've banged more guys than that.
Doggy.
What about, Val Kilmer's another one, too.
Oh, Val Kilmer, that's
Val
right.
Kilmer's another one. I don't know why I know so much about her, but I don't like her. I'm not a fan of her. I hate her movies. I hope she goes broke.
She's a freak.
Yeah.
Absolute freak.
These celebrity broads are banging everybody, by the way, and they're friggin' pig animals.
You get it?
All right. I mean, I'm just telling you how it
Wouldn't
I feel.
You?
No, I wouldn't.
You guys ready for another one?
Yeah, go to the next one.
You guys seem into it. So, this London-born actress looks like if David Bowie and Annex Lady had a baby. Annie Lennox had a baby on
Broken
Glass.
Looks like
Jesus Christ.
She could easily pass as an albino and is playing an 82-year-old man in the upcoming movie Suspiria. Machine Gun, would you rather make out with or stake out Tilda Swinton?
Stake out.
She make out with the guy looking
She needs a steak. Look, you can see her hot piece. She's freaking nasty. Are you kidding me right now? What is that? No. Get out of here. Give her food, the poor thing. Is that one of the kids that Angelina Jolie has over there in the other country? Oh, man.
She's a handsome woman.
She's definitely handsome.
Yeah.
Jesus.
I could see McCluskey and her laying next to each other.
Upside down.
Man.
I need to split the difference between an elf and Nick Nolte. I'm somewhere in the middle there. All right, you guys ready for another one of these disgusting human beings? This Oscar winner has played boxers, teachers, and Daniel LaRusso, but a breakthrough role was playing a trans guy in Boys Don't Cry. Mr. Monday, would you rather make out or stake out with Hilary Swank?
I would never make out with her. You see her teeth, her chompers? She would bite your lips and your tongue off all at once.
Are you serious?
Well, you ever see the teeth in this chick?
Are you talking about the guy thing?
No, really.
She looks good.
She'd make your pricklet, your hot dog look like a grizzled piece of beef.
It's okay. She's good looking. You think she's ugly?
I don't. I mean, just I'm talking about her teeth. Her teeth are disgusting.
Oh, yeah, maybe. All right?
She'd bite everything off.
It's all right.
She's got beluga teeth.
She's not bad. She's not bad.
Did you guys see the sequel to Boys Don't Cry? It was Mike Can't Tell.
I'd rather make out with the... Listen, I would rather make out with the male version than the female version of this one. Listen, I'm just letting you know, guys, okay? I'm not a homophobic like Mike.
All right, this 50-year-old pretty woman has been blessed with a huge mouth to go along with a lot of teeth. She's been a staple since the 1990s and a famously dressed as a man to avoid her psycho husband and sleeping with the enemy.
Oh, yeah.
I forgot about that part, but I liked that movie. Oh, Mike, would you rather make out with Julia or stake out?
Julia Roberts?
All day long, make out.
That mouth is too big for me.
Because you're a half a man, that's why. When you're a half a man, that's what happens. She's perfect.
How many minutes would you make out with her? All together. Like, would you tell her you loved her?
Can I pull her hair?
You could do whatever you want to her.
Oh, definitely half an hour.
Half
an hour.
Half an hour?
She's nice. You don't like her? Come on, you don't think she's good
looking? No, I like Julia Roberts. I'm a big fan of her. I like Julia Roberts. Yeah, always have.
All day.
Remember the movie Pretty Woman? She's been in some good ones.
Oh, she had the short things on and she was walking the streets.
Yeah. Right. She was a hooker, right?
She was a hooker.
She was a hooker in that movie.
Call Girl.
Lady of the Night.
I like her.
Is that the last one?
She looks like she's got a friggin' coat hanger stuck in her mouth, doesn't she?
She's a friggin'
like she's
idiot.
Always driving with her head outside of a car.
Who's your favorite? You know? All right, out of these four broads that you mentioned,
he doesn't know.
Which one would you like the best?
I like the one that looks like David Bowie.
Of course you do. Of course you do.
Really?
Which one is that?
It explains everything.
You would suck. Would you suck her neck?
If it was lower, no.
Idiot.
All right.
Something's wrong with it.
All right, we're going to take another quick break. I want you to check out Bubba Yeager's new adventure from Tossville Fair. Bubba Yeager is a smash sensation lately. He's unbelievable. And we'll be right back to close things out.
Yeah. All right.
Martha R. Bagley Esquire is a lawyer specializing in family law, divorce, litigation planning, and negotiation and settlements. With two convenient locations, Bagley Law in Salem and Weston Patrick in Boston, Martha is the choice for the Massachusetts seacoast. Going through a divorce can be one of the hardest things we have to do. Don't make it harder than it has to be. Call 978-745-0066 today.
All right, all you punxsutawney Bills, we're getting together here, the heartland of America, the District of Columbia, Walmart, New Hampshire, here at the Tossville Fair. We got some pig races coming up. Me and Mr. Monday got a score to settle. He owes me 150 clams from last week. So what do we got? We got some pig races. I got $100 in the one, obviously. Who you got?
I got the three.
The three horse. Of course
you think
would.
He's an expert in pigs.
Of course you would.
Pig.
Yeah, of course you would. Yeah, the Madonna on the Revere Parkway. Here we go, folks. This is how much more America, unless it had bacon, a cheeseburger, and a pizza on it, you can't get much more American than this. I'd bomb us, too.
Can we talk about the fans, please?
Look at the bleachers. They made bleachers to run pigs in a circle. Can you imagine how good we're doing here as a country? Bomb everything else and put stands around it and let our farm animals and chickens run in a circle.
They're looking at us like there's something wrong with us.
Yeah, right. We're the weirdos. Yeah. I never felt more home in my life.
I know.
Look at that.
Scissor me.
Look at that. They got jacuzzi in the middle there. It's like Tampa Bay Stadium. The Devil Rays are playing.
The thing's going to be swimming.
Oh, it's almost like an obstacle court, that equestrian thing they do at Suffolk Downs. They jump over the fences and run down the Linway. Get a shot of that crowd. They all came here and they got their vouchers from buying Walmart 15% off on a Tuesday and get a free ticket to this dump. This is America, folks. This is why we've been at war for the last 35 years. So you can run pigs around a trough and get some deep fried Oreos. America. Where are these pigs, man? Enough of this bullshit. I can't look at these people anymore. Oh my God. Looks like a Dots catalog. Jesus Christ. I had more fun at my mother's funeral. Holy
Jesus Christ.
You gotta be. Here he goes! Yeah! Thank God they play there. I call redraft.
Barack Obama won.
Of course he did.
Of course he did.
12 years in office, that's all we get.
That's scumbag.
Oh, frozen tundra! Frozen tundra! Welcome back. Welcome back, everyone. What a great Monday it's been. Klusky, let's do some fan art here, and let's close out the night.
I love the fan art. We get so much of it, we don't put enough on, honestly. But you guys should keep sending them in. Eventually, we'll get to it, all right? So don't get, you know.
The fan art's legit.
It is. Just don't get frustrated. It'll end up eventually on there. This first one is from Rosie Skeeter, 51-year-old from Saugus. She says she's a big fan of our Silver Fox co-host, Figgy, and she was really upset when he was a no-show a few weeks back. It upset her, and this is, you know, a depressed photo that she drew.
It's a little weird. Figgy's mother's name is Rosie, too, by the way.
Is it really?
Yeah. Okay.
A fan is a fan.
And, you know, and 51's kind of old for Figgy because there's a lot of young girls, because he does a lot of selfies on Instagram.
I know. Yeah, he's great. Just ask him.
And he does a lot. It's pretty. That's an old chick to like this guy, because there's like 21-year-olds, 31s. They're loving this guy.
He's terrific.
I was at a wedding with him last night. Should have seen his hair. The silver fox. He was like dancing. He's got the moves.
Very handsome.
Is this a confession?
I mean, he had the moves last night. He was moving. No, I'm just talking about.
No, not you. I'm saying, is this Rosie saying that the reason Figgy wasn't there is because she was with Rosie?
No way. He's a loyal guy to his wife.
Oh, all right. Under the bus.
Oh, I'm not. I just.
What's your problem?
Hey, listen, his wife might box your face in next time she sees you. All right, she could take Richie LaMontagne, his wife Maria.
No joke.
But I'll tell you, Figgy the Silver Fox, we missed him. You know, it's too bad he skipped out on us that night.
Sign an autograph somewhere.
Coaching football.
Maybe it's a misery. Maybe it's a threat. Maybe it's one of those things. She's going to kidnap him.
He has high demands for the show. He wanted a raise and everything.
Here we go.
And what are you going
to
do?
Le'Veon Bell. All right.
What do we got next?
Moving along. This next drawing is from Sammy D from Cape Cod. After hearing Polly the Shark call into our show a few weeks back, he was inspired to send us an action drawing of one of our favorite sharks ripping somebody's leg off. Remember the shark that ate the kid from Revere?
Oh, geez, yeah.
He called in, and somebody must have just appreciated that.
Yeah, Sammy's a sick kid, okay, Sammy? Someone died. This isn't funny. You know, someone got killed. The kid from Revere got eaten by a shark, and this kid, Sammy, sending us this stuff.
Yeah, but it looks
like it's a Sammy kid.
He's young, right?
Sammy's 23. He's studying to be a marine biologist and a mortician.
After that show.
You're studying to be a marine biologist?
Is that your foot,
and a mortician.
McCall, is that your foot with the painted toenails?
No,
no, that's his foot right there with the painted toenails.
Yeah.
So this, Sammy, honestly, keep doing the art here, but, you know, come on, clean it up a little bit. Help us out. All right, what do we got next?
The last entry is from Chichi from Malden. He loves children, Cane's Donuts, and he loved Peasy's tirade. We had a comedian on, a great, great comedian, Johnny Peasy.
Oh, yeah.
And he was upset with Cane's Donuts. He said, no matter what happens, he will never stop eating those donuts or going to Prince Pizza. Chichi loved Johnny Peasy.
So, Chichi, I mean, I got to think the kid's probably Mexican or something.
What do you think so?
You know, he likes pizzas and donuts. I mean, how many Mexicans like pizza and donuts?
Well, Carly, you can't eat Mexican for breakfast.
Right. I mean, what's this guy eating? Pastelitos? I mean, he's talking about this stuff. What's going on with this guy? Maybe him and Peasy got something going on. I don't know.
Well, when you have breakfast at 10:30, you can eat whatever you want, right?
It works until midnight.
What happened with Cane's Donuts?
I think they have to move based on like how much volume they're doing.
Oh, they're moving to Cane's Donuts is moving to a new spot. They won't be too far. They won't be too far from where they are. And Johnny Peasy's gonna be real happy about it. What else? Tell me a little more about Chichi, because you know him, don't you?
I went to his Facebook page and I read a couple poems by him. Would you like me to read one?
Yes.
I don't know if this is appropriate for the.
Is it R-rated?
It's worse than that.
Yeah, no, don't.
Some of these words are Spanish. I don't know if I'm saying something anti-Semitic. I don't want to take a risk.
Let's table that to the next show.
Yeah, let's do that.
All right, guys. Look, another Monday's here. Another Monday's over. Monday's always here. It never gives up. Just like Mr. Monday. I never give up. I always win. All right? And these guys always win. So if you never give up, you're always going to be a winner. Monday on three. One, two, three. Monday!
Summer's coming. Get your chain chomped. You universal sizes, one fits all. Get your dress shirt for your summer wearing. Get your summer tank tops, gray or black. Black makes it look thin. Get your tank tops, summer's coming. I got thousands of tank tops to sell. Let's go, the summer's here. Summer's here, summer's here. You want to get a suit coat for the summer? For your summer wedding? Let's go! I Love Monday t-shirts back in stock. We shelved it up. Monday hoodies on sale. Buy a bunch of them. Flat brim breaking balls hats like the millennials wear. Wedding season's coming. Get your dress shirt. The original I Love Monday t-shirt. Let's go, you scumbag!